Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of Horizons S&P. Thank you for coming today and hanging out with yo boys. I was just doing a quick little mining session. So last night I ended up streaming here on the Horizons S&P server, and a ton happened. So it originally started out as trying to decorate the interior of my home. Let's clear this out because I think we're going to have a little bit of a fight. It looks like it's nighttime. So I decorated the interior of the home, and then Chronic Scribe, he joined into the server. We ended up streaming together. We did a ton of stuff. We made our way to the Nether. It's a raining too. Yeesh. We made our way to the Nether. We found a Nether fortress. I got some blaze rods and such, and then we decided to head to the end. We ended up searching several end cities. This rain is crazy. It's probably super loud. Let's turn that down just a little bit. Yeesh. But we searched several end cities because people had been to the end before. Finally, we found a couple that had a set of wings and a couple shulker boxes. So I ended up taking my wings off. Let's get inside here. We're safe real quick. Okay. Yikes. Oh, I killed a zombie. He had a carrot. So now we have carrots, potatoes, and wheat. So our farm situation's coming along. Eventually, we'll get a proper farm set up somewhere out through here. But here's my nice little home. You guys saw the exterior of it in the last episode. I say last night, I'm recording this Thursday day. We had a stream Wednesday night. But here's the interior of the situation. I still got some housekeeping. We still got our chests and stuff out there in this chest here. It's not going to be here. We're probably going to have some more decoration, maybe an armor stand or something down here. But this is what I decided on our little stairway situation. We just threw like our lectern over to the side, a couple bookshelves and chests, an ender chest. You can see we got the shulker shells up in here. Here's some of the other stuff we got from the end as well. I got a diamond sword. I got a diamond pickaxe with efficiency 4. So we haven't made our first diamond pick just yet, but we have Electra. Couple nice books that I found in the stronghold, as well as some other end items. I think it was a very fun and productive time that speeds us up a lot because I've been missing my wangs. But here's our kitchen area. Let me know what you guys think about this. We worked it out on stream together. Some of us got our little oven area with our stove tops with the activator rails or detector rails. Actually, I think it turned out pretty good. Some food storage, maybe it's there for storage or to dry out or something. We got like a little preparation plate. I did that chimney right here when I built the exterior of it, and I wasn't a big fan of having like the oven and an open fire here, but I think it turned out pretty well. So that's the decoration. Now the storage area is actually very plain. It's just I typically do two wide chests side by side like that. Didn't work out that way, just the way the design is. So this would be a decent little starter storage. And then finally we ended up decorating the interior of the bedroom. I ran some logs down on the sides here to kind of enclose it, hung some lights and such, made a little desk area. I think it turns out pretty nice. The chair's okay. And then I moved the bed from there to over here. Now, we got to do some carpets, so I got to get some wool situation down. But I also, off camera, I did some exploring, found a jungle, found a few villages and such. We got a little pet parrot. I think he's a good addition to the family. But let's go ahead and sleep real quick. It probably won't stop the rain, but it'll definitely pass the night away. So the plan for today, I got to do a slime farm. I'm going to start the beginnings of that. It's going to be down in the mine. And then over to the side, out that-a-way. Yes, there's a skeleton spawner. I found that joker, lit it up. We're going to turn that into a bone farm. I think it'll be pretty nice. Then if we have time, we might actually start on a villager breeder because we are in dire need of needing some good books, that's for sure. I have some diamonds around here somewhere. It's up in the bedroom. I've got several diamonds now. That's pretty good, probably half a stack or so. But progress is being made. Got spruce. We have spruce now. I forgot I planted a temporary tree farm over there. So it's moving along. So let's get to work on that slime farm, I think, to start with. Let's do it. That's what I'm talking about. A little bit of slime farm going on. So this design is very simple. It's a video I saw by Nbomb. I'll tag that down in the description, put the link there. Of course, I have to dress it up and such, and it can be expanded upon, but the beauty of this is it's so simple. It's a very early game slime farm design. Just come down here to check it. I did a small amount of AFK, so just to make sure it's working, and it seems to be. So we have our first slime balls. You see the new recipe unlock. The way this works is, well, eventually this is all going to be dug out. So that there's no blocks between this right here and the sky. This is all the way down at Y7. So it's bedrock's just like right under that level there, I believe. But the way that this works is it doesn't really matter. You don't have to have any crazy stuff attracting the slimes to the side and all that, because the slimes are going to jump around. And it doesn't take much, and then they'll end up just hopping right off. Of course, the bigger you go, there's some things you need to change, you need to alter a little bit to make it more efficient, but essentially once they hop off, they get washed right to the corners on each side, and the magma blocks will kill them and or kill the slimes, or at least make them too smaller, because it's the small slimes that make the slime balls. And the way that this works with these chests is no matter what, like if you take an item, oh I'm dying, let's get an item really quick, let's just get this piece of cobble, and you'll see even though those chests are there, it'll still go through that space and then picked up by the hopper and into a chest. So let's slow this down. And as you can see from this tutorial, so let's walk around. So we got 5 slime blocks already. And let's just see how many we got. Ooh, rip Jigglypuff. Rip. F in the chat. So, I think the beauty of this is that it's pretty well just passive. I mean, we may not have much. I only AFK'd for just a second just to see if it would work. But while I'm up top and around the base working, this thing's going to be pumping out the slime. So that's the best part about this whole situation. So not much. There's our piece of cobble. Only 6 pieces of slime, but it's 6 more than we had. And now it can continue to work as we're building the next steps of our base, which I think is fantastic. So the next part that we're going to try to work on now is get that skeleton farm up and running. Hopefully you guys don't mind time lapses. Let me know in the description if you like these small short bursts of just the work getting done, because usually I would just cut and then bring you back when it's done or halfway through, but I like the time lapse. It shows me doing the work and keeps you guys filled in as far as that process goes. But let's get to working on it, baby. So now we have a fully functioning skeleton farm. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that little time lapse of that being built as well. Like I was saying before, if you like these, let me know, because I'm not sure how that feels to everybody else. I personally enjoy it, but you know, I think I'm a little biased. But now we have a bone farm. We got arrows and bows rolling in, so that'd be fantastic. But the bones is what I'm mainly interested in, and it's not too shabby on the XP. So you saw the way that it was built out there. Pretty much they'll just spawn and get washed down the central hole right there and into a water elevator up and drop 19 blocks, and it's just one hitter quitters from that point. Did I use all them blocks? I don't know. But the next step to this is I don't want mobs cap to be an issue, so I'm gonna, once I have the resources, make some redstone lamps and line this situation. That way I just have a switch where I can turn the lights on, they'll stop spawning, and then turn the lights off when I'm ready to activate the farm. So that'll be the next step in the situation. She's off. Oof. So I just got exploded all over the place. I got a big hole in the ground, got my stuff, and got some things situated. But when I don't know if you noticed in that little me getting exploded all over the place, that was awful. Seen some people landing, flying in over at my house, and I think it was Blue and Ryan. So let's go check out what they was doing. What y'all doing up at my house for? But been pretty fun, been pretty productive. I think that slime farm, give me those, thank you. That slime farm and that bone farm, that skeleton farm will be very beneficial, especially this early game, you know what I'm saying? Alright, so what's going on here? Everything looks the same. Yes, Enderman? Enderman much? Come on, yo. Leave grass block on my grass. Oh, there's a chest right here. What we got? Let me make sure everything's cool. See nothing crazy. Oh my good. Hey buddy, this is from Blue. Okay, so let's see what this say. Friends. Hey buddy, welcome to the server. Here's some gifts from me and Ryan to help you on your way. Blue and Ryan. Oh, what a bunch of sweethearts. Look at this stuff. We have Unbreaking 3 and Mending. That's gonna go perfect for our set of wings. Yes, yeah. Where's my wings? I think I put them up in here. I did. Okay, so we're definitely going to have to throw those onto those wings. You got a diamond block, some emeralds, and fireworks, and iron. That's fantastic. Blue and Ryan, thank you, baby. I appreciate it. That's much appreciated. That'll be put to good use. Definitely going to need them diamonds because it's almost time for some diamond armor. I ended up, when I got blowed up, blow-splodied, I keep headbutting my microphone with my headphones. Sheesh. Lost my chest plate, so I had to throw this golden chest plate on from a, I think, zombie that I killed. So definitely need to up the armor game, up the tools as well. So I'm going to have to do some more mining real soon. I think our diamond situation, aside from that new block, is 26. Oh, nope. 29. Fantastic. So yeah, I think everything's coming along pretty well. Now I think I'm going to do a stream tonight when I'm recording this, which right now it's Thursday. So tonight I'm going to do a stream. And I think on that stream we're going to work out the villager breeder. And I'm probably going to do it as a time lapse in this video. So hopefully when you guys are seeing this, it's Saturday afternoon. I'm going to be sleeping because, yeah, you know, I'll be working the midnights and stuff. But yeah, let's see how it goes. Stream did not go so well, but this is what you missed when I ended up cutting the stream off. I ended up filling in the rest of the crops, and then I just kind of AFK'd and hung out around these villagers. You can see as it spins around here, he's tossing carrots into them, and they'll start to breed. And I continued the path on underground, so you can see the stairway goes on around, and right down here at the bottom is a little fella. He already been born, and you should see a second one. Boop! Yeah, just like that. So this is a design by Impulse SV, and it works fantastic. I've used it in my previous world. So the way it works is this villager inside, he's harvesting the crops inside, and as his inventory gets full, he comes over and chucks the carrots over to these villagers right here. Now there's four beds that are claimed by these two villagers as well as this one. The system's going to notice that there's an extra bed that needs to be filled, so they're going to continue to breed. But what happens is the babies are going to fall down here and get washed away. Now, you saw in that little time-lapse situation, they get washed over to here down the set of steps. I fixed the water so they reach a one block wide, like, air gap. And they just sit there. And once they grow, there's water above them, and they'll swim up, and they come into this once they're fully grown. And I'm going to store all of my villagers there so we can do the underground trading hall. But I've changed this just a little bit. Let's go over here. Once I get up, sheesh, you can see this dirt pillar. I've blocked off the stairway down, the waterway down, and I need to block this off as well. And ran them over here for right now because we want to do an iron farm. I think I'm going to do it up there somewhere. But right down here is an opening, And any new babies that are born, they should get washed into here and they'll hang out. That way, closer to the surface, excuse me, where's all my dirt? So what should happen, being closer to the surface, it'll be easier for me to scoop them out and take six of them, probably 25 blocks or so up into the sky. Let's see, I fill this in really quick. Yeah, I did the stream on this, and I almost forgot to start the replay mod, which was almost a catastrophe, but I remembered about a fourth of the way into building the structure of it, and then my stream just kept breaking. I've never had that issue before, but we're making progress, as you can see. I now have all diamond armor and tools down the inventory there. So that's working out pretty well, and we got our villager breeder. Next step is going to be the iron farm and the trading hall, and hopefully you guys have enjoyed this episode. If you did, make sure you hit that thumbs up button. If you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe to the channel and hit that little bell icon so every time I upload, you can come hang out with your boy. We'll see you next time. See ya. Bye-bye.